All right, here we go. How's everybody doing today? Happy Wednesday, the 27th of May. Hope everybody had a enjoyable, modified Memorial weekend. That's what I'm going to call it. I'm trying to pull up my chat here on my phone so I can see what the heck we're talking about there. So good evening, how is everybody doing tonight? Good evening, Frank. We got Frank in the house. We got Jessica in the house. We are going to be tying ourselves up some synthetic streamers, some synthetic minnows, some little mini minnows. There we go. Let's get this plugged back in. Set this up to the side so I can see what's being said while we chat along. So, how's everybody doing? Let's go ahead and check in. We got Dale Sanders in the house. Good evening. So, what do you guys and gals think? We worked our way through the hairline dubbing material kit. I do not expect anybody to have tried to have keep along with that as I was putting those videos out, but the best part is those 20 videos are archived in a playlist and available for you to reference if you so choose. You know, it was a definitely a fun experience working through these flies. The top 20 patterns for beginners, and each and every pattern, as I worked my way through, it just kind of started to make more sense, and I appreciate it. Plenty of material left over. The only downside is you run out of hooks before you run out of anything else, and like I said at the beginning of that, you know, if they included a ton more hooks, well, that would just jack up the price immensely on those. Great little kit. I know there's always some discussion, especially on some of the fly fishing Facebook groups. You know, should you get a kit? Some people swear by them. Some people will just say they're garbage. Don't bother. They say find a pattern or two and just buy the material for that. Well, after you get done with the fly or two with just those two bits of material, then you're forced to go back out to the fly shop. And you know, if you are not traveling, if you have a fly shop that's a great distance away, you know, this little beginner kit, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go back and I'm gonna reload it up with some hooks and just keep it to the side. Maybe I'll have my wife tie it, or maybe she can work her way through the book more than just having to listen to me. So, yeah. Jess says the kit rocks. Yes. It was fun. It was definitely a fun experience. Oh, yeah. It's a $100-plus kit. But you go through it, and you end up with quite a bit of material. A little bit of a lot of bit. 60 some odd different bits and parts in it, I think. So anyways. Well, let's slide on over to the bench and see if we can't tie up some of these synthetic hair minnows. Get that camera to slide on over. So in the past, at our Project Healing Waters program, what we have done is we've basically have tied the exact same thing. We've used the big dogs, and we used wig synthetic hair extension material. And I really didn't want to pull that all out and make a huge, huge mess. So what I'm going to be using is a equivalent. And this stuff is called Congo hair. I know Frank probably has some, and a couple other fly tyers that have been hanging around me for quite some time might have some of this on hand. And this is a golden shad, and this is basically a mixture of some different colors of a synthetic hair. And we're gonna play with this tonight. This is one of those you pull it out of the bag, and you know, just like everything else, when we cut it, we're gonna make sure we get nice and close. So NCDOC1Hundo is in the house. He says good evening, NC Doc. What does NC Doc represent, if I may ask? So that's gonna be the top portion of our fly. Underneath is going to be the same, just in white. So this is going to be essentially what we're going to be going for our fly. If it was a big giant fly, maybe it would look something like that. Anyways, I also have just a little bit of yellow flash. This is a same company, Fly Tyers Dungeon Northern Lights Flash. And I also wanted to probably introduce a little bit of crystal flash. Here is some pearl and a little bit of red. I believe minnows are just minnows unless they have eyes, and then they become flies. Or maybe that's the other way around. I don't know. You be the judge. So who wants to guess what hook we have in the vise? Any guesses? Who has been paying attention thus far? I'll give you a clue. It's a size 2. Size 2 hook. Any guesses? Get our hair. Put this back in the box. We'll start tying, and we'll let people guess what hook we have in the vise. For my thread, I'm using a white. See, it's a 140 denier. But before I do my thread, add a little bit of wire. This is a lead-free round wire. Pinch that on nice and tight. We're going to give this just a little bit of weight. Front. Just pause there and get that lay down there nice and tight. Okay, we're gonna line that up, I don't know, right about the tip of the hook. We're gonna wrap our wire forward. Just guess the size 8. Well, it's a size 2. And our hook is the Mustad 3366. That's the golden standard when we're talking fly tying for Project Healing Water St. Cloud program. So I was an FMF Corman when I was on AD, so we'll translate that. I don't know what FMF, fireside, medical something. I know Corman. Corman's medical, and when I was on AD, active duty. FMF. I'm curious what. See, now we just got to go a little bit deeper. What a FMF is. That's a fine mother. Friend. It's a fine mother friend. Fine mother, a field. I don't know. Anyways, gotta stop staring at the chat. Dale Sanders got it right, 3366. Alright, we'll start our thread. Eyes length behind the eye. Aye, aye. Actually, you know what? I'm going to go just a little bit, oop, a little bit closer up front. Wasn't quite that eye's length. So, alright, let's go ahead and work our thread from the front to the rear over top of that lead-free wire. There we have it. Just like that. Fleet Marine Force. Here we go. Semper Fi. Hurrah! I like Marines. Marines are fun. Alright, we'll wrap our thread. Put it over this wire a few times. Just locking that in nice and tight. Beautiful. Alright. So, let's take a look at this Congo hair, if we will. A couple of big long stragglies. Begone. Josh Anderson checking in. Good evening. Good evening. Alright, so let's go ahead and take some of this hair. And I'm going for kind of more of that yellowish, goldish bit in there. And take a chunk, probably about that. And this is going to be our whole fly. Trim that off nice and close. And now we're going to multiply by dividing. This is going to be way more than for one fly. This will be like a fly and a half. So anyways, I'm just going to kind of, let's see, let me measure this out. This is 1, 2, 3, about 4 inches. And if we look, let's see, I bet you this is about 1, 2, 3, 4. What a coincidence. About 4 hooks length. So let's go ahead and just start off with a little bit. The name of this game is keeping it sparse. Sparse is, as we know, pretty nice. A little bit mixed in there. And if you guys have these handy brushes, great opportunity to just kind of brush these out. And what we're looking for on the ends of our little clumps of hair is a tapered end. We don't necessarily want everything in one clean cut. So, over here, that looks like a pretty nice clean cut. So we're going to just kind of taper that out. Slide that through your fingers. There you go. Alright, lift and lower technique. We're going to lift our material right on top, right about halfway. We're going to do a couple tight wraps. And we're going to fold this back and let it join its friend. Now what I don't want to do is I don't want to, you know what? Yeah, I don't want to wrap on top. I just want to wrap in front. And I'm going to build a little thread dam. And advance my thread forward just a little bit. And we're going to grab another little clump. It's going to be just a little bit of a wash, rinse, and repeat. Go ahead and taper that out. Remember, sparse is nice, more or less. And brush that out if you want. So my piece of hair is about 4 inches. And I think maybe I'm going to go 1, 2, 3. I'm going to do this 3 times. Couple of wraps right on top. Now we're going to go and we're going to start preparing our white. And our bits for our belly for our white is going to be a little bit shorter here. So I'm going to fold this over once. Trim my loop. I'm going to fold this over twice. So off to the side, I guess I could have done this at the beginning. I have some of the hair that for the top, and I have some hair for the bottom. There we go. So 4 inches and about 2 inches. All right, we'll take our little 2-inch pinch. Taper that out a little bit. Sparse is nice. Let's not jam it up too heavy. Alright, I like to go just kind of on the far side. I'll pinch up on it. A couple of wraps. And this is where our good friend Mr. Bick comes in, because watch this, just take that, fold it all back, and remember, we're just wrapping in front, we're not wrapping on top, and I suppose I could just take a second and just kind of spread that onto either side of the shank of the hook, or the bend of the hook, rather. Right in front of that, we're going to build a little dam. That's going to be it. Advance forward a little bit. We're going to go right about midway. I like this little kind of golden shiner or golden shad. Taper the ends. I got a little something on there. Got it. Alright, here we go. Lift and lower. Set it right on top. 50-50. Take a couple of wraps. Add our little pinch on the bottom. It goes on nice and easy when it kind of gets fluffed out a little bit. Okay, about 50-50. Excellent, nice and tight. And I guess if we wanted, we could be adding a little dab of glue in between all this. But I don't know. I'm feeling kind of lazy, and I just want to tie. All right. Again, we're not wrapping on top like that. We're just wrapping in front. That's going to help that just kind of really build its body out. And this really gets small as we added the water. Alright, so now for my last pinch. After I taper this out, I'm not going to tie it on exactly at 50-50. So I want this nice big long piece to swoop about full length. So we're going to have a long portion of it facing forward. We'll take our couple of wraps. I like to pinch it around the shank of the hook, at least around the top side. Give it a little belly. And I can definitely feel like I went a little heavy on this one. So we're going to have to go a little bit sparse. The white underneath will go, keep that at the 50-50 length. Slide that all back. Probably just, you know, I'm just going to add a little bit more flash and stuff up front. I'd like to have gotten this just a little bit closer to the eye of the hook up front, but I would rather just let it be what it is here and now than try to force something that doesn't really want it to work. Here we go. Now we can see the whole fly. Flash and add some of this yellow on top. And I'm going to want that to kind of go the full length. Out. So I encourage everybody to find some synthetic hair of some sorts and try your best to see what you can come up with. I know some of the participants have been out and about and went the local beauty hair supply and hooked up on some synthetic wig hair. Here we go, we're gonna add some crystal flash. Let's see, let's just go 1, 2, 3. Lift and lower technique is we can lift and lower and bring it all the way to the near side of the hook too. So I'm going to run this right on the side, right between the white and the yellow goldish on top. And we'll do the same thing on this far side. I'm just tying these in full length right at the halfway point. Really get some full length out of that. Alright, I'll keep coning that down. And one last little batch of flash. What do you say? Let's do some red crystal flash. A little flash will do ya. Alright, so with this, I'm just going to go with a couple of strands. Why? Because we're going to multiply by dividing. Fold it in half. 2 becomes 4. Fold it in half again. 4. Count 8. I think that'll be just fine. We'll take that right on underneath. I'm going to trim this down just a little bit. Even up those ends. That nice tight head. Actually, I guess we could have got just a little bit closer up front, but that'll be all right. All right, we'll finish this off with a 1-2-3 whip finish. Looks good, but where's the flash? We added the flash. Bit of flash on top. We got a little bit of flash on the side. We got a little flash on the bottom. I think we should have added some flash at the very beginning. That's what we should do. But I think we should definitely go through and tie another one after this. All right, so let's find our glue, and I'm going to be using some gel control Loctite, because we're going to stick on some eyes, and with a size 2, this 1/4 inch seems to be just about right. Carefully take one of these off. But I guess before I go gluing on eyes, let me just take a brush to this. Be mindful of that tip of that hook in there. That'll definitely reach out and bite you. Also, underneath here, with the flat part of my scissors, I compress that down. Doesn't need too much. That's going to give our eyes a little bit of a flatter surface to stick on to. Alright, let's see if we can't get a little dab of glue right on the bottom. That in. I'm going to wash, rinse, and repeat. I suppose what we could also just do is just add the dab of glue right there. Stick on. Drop the cap. Okay, now before we go too far, we're going to add a little bit of resin. And this is, you can go through and you can add a few coats of some Sally Hansen's, but what's really going to work best is some of this Solar Res. This is a thin hard, so I'm just going to come in and raise my light. Always make sure, if you're dinking around with these UV resins, take a second, going to come in right around the eyes and fill in the area right in between the eyes. This is kind of a thin, hard. So a little dab. Thing right underneath, a little dab of resin. And what I'm looking at here is I'm looking at to connect the eyes underneath, really. And what's nice is I can do it in stages. I don't feel like I have to just go bananas. Bella asked, what are we tying? Well, it is just a little, call it a Goldie. Not a Goldie. There's a pattern out there called a Goldie already. Just a little golden minnow. Nicolon. That's it, Nicolon. Is its scientific name. If you buy it from the Fly Tyers Dungeon, they call it Congo hair. A little bit more refined, a little bit of a blend. But let's just add water to this and see what happens. One last little splash of resin. I want just to seal in over those eyes just a little bit more. We'll just use our brush on for that. The thread head up front just got a little bit out of the way, a little out of hand, but I think it turned out all right. Yeah, so this one's just a little bit too dense. I really want this to be more sparse. Sparse is nice. This is pretty thick, pretty heavy, but it should work. It should work. So there you have it. That's our first little kind of, we'll call that the chunky minnow. Chunky Goldie, chunky golden shiner, golden shad. It's a fun one. You're definitely not going to crank out a whole bunch of these quick, fast, and in a hurry. So, looks like we got a few more have all tuned in. We're doing all right today. It is a beautiful Wednesday. I got out in my little boat today, and it was an epic fail. Well, maybe not an epic fail, but I had to go back, and I'm re-gluing on my oar locks and some other bits and parts. I got out there today, and it wasn't pretty. Let's just say that I know what I'm doing when it comes to tying knots and lashing things down to inflatable pontoons. She held air, at least while we were there, but we got back to the house and, leaking a little bit of air. But, you know, what do you do? move forward, I suppose. Come home and take care of it and decompress and tie a fly. That's some good stuff. So, speaking of tying a fly, let's go ahead and just jump in and start a second one. We're going to remember to keep this one a little bit more sparse. Right? Sparse is... nurse. Sparse is nurse. Alright, let's do this. Move this big old sample out of the way. Zip it A. Alright. I need to just take a second and adjust my chair. My button got bumped and I was low riding. I needed to ride it a little bit higher. Alright, let's try this again. Good old Mustad 3366, size 2 in the vise. And we'll come in with some lead-free wire. You can go heavier, you can go lighter, you can go not at all. I like to add just a little bit of weight. Take a few wraps and then clean up that back end. And you can also use that almost like a little ratchet. Kind of help get that last little pigtail down. This all the way forward. About an eye's length behind the eye. Eye. And last time it didn't want a helicopter off, so I'm gonna use my nippers. Get that a nice clean cut. Oh yeah, Dave, I'll be getting in contact with you tomorrow. I need to get some vinyl. So we can add a little bit of added patchwork to my inflatable floatable. All right, let's get on here with our white thread. I'm using a 140 denier. Take a few wraps up front, and as we wrap into our thread, we'll just hang on to that tag end. Let it ride all the way to the back. Give it a little compression forward. And bada boom, bada bing. Alright, so what we didn't do last time, which we're going to do this time, is we're going to add a little bit of flash on the back end. It's going to be the same flash as the top, I think. Yeah. Just a couple of strands or so. Don't need to go two bananas. 1, 2, 3, 4. Because it's going to fold over. And lower, right at the 50-50. Fold that back. We're going to wrap right on top of that. I think that'll work. Alright, now we're going to add our hair. And this one, we're going to keep it a little bit more sparse. this synthetic hair. Take a big chunk. And I'll fold it in half. And this is the section that I'm actually working with. I'm not tying this whole bit in. I'm just going to grab a little bit of that hair off. All right, so we got this nice clean tapered end. Sometimes I can, I'm going to taper that out. And if you taper this end, guess what happens to this end? It gets tapered as well. Alright, so let's just go ahead and tie this in right at about that 50-50 point. Couple of wraps, nice and tight. Fold that back. Now we're going to wrap right in front of that. Building a dam, we're not wrapping on top. All right, now let's do that again. Go ahead and lift and lower that right on. About that 50-50 point. A couple of locking wraps, and we're going to go underneath. Split that into two pieces, almost like a Y. And then we'll set that right on underneath. A couple of soft wraps to capture it. Make sure it's lined up properly. Take our magic pen. Now we're going to wrap in front. Again, we're not wrapping on top, we're wrapping in front. We're building a little dome, or a little bullet head in front. That'll work. We'll advance our thread forward a little bit. I'm going to do that again. Oh, I got the glue. I just don't have the raw fabric that I need. The patch material. I think I found a spot online that does that sort of thing. Gold on top and a little bit of white on bottom. And the tool that makes it all so helpful is this little Bic tool. Bic never knew they were making fly tying tools, but boy, it works. you can play barber or salon stylist later on if you want. Trim that hair down a little bit if it's just a little bit too much for you. Alright, so this last piece, I want to tie it in a little bit longer, facing forward, about the full fly's length. Couple of wraps. Also, Mr. Frank, I'm going to be making a speedy delivery at your place tomorrow, so stand by for a phone call. One last time, I'll just kind of push that back. And if you don't have a deconstructed Bic pen to do that, don't worry. Dab-a-do. Alright, we're going to add a little bit of flash on top. Maybe on our next one we're going to add some flash inside of it as we tie along. What do you think of that? Get a little gold for the top. Ooh, I like that. Let's get some crystal for the side. So with the crystal flash, what I do is I cut the corner of that bag, and I can use my whip finish tool. I can just take out a couple of strands as needed. All right, I'm going to do 1, 2, 3 per side. Rinse and repeat on the far side, which coincidentally that was one of my favorite books growing up, comic books, The Far Side, always made me laugh. Alright, couple of wraps, and we'll fold this back. Right along the lateral edge. Alright, one last little bit of flash. What do you say? Let's add some red. And for this, what did I do? 2 strands? 2 or 3? 2 to 3 strands. You don't have to go bananas on it. If you don't have any red crystal flash, just red flash will do. If you don't have any red flash will do, a little red marker. Well, if you don't have any red marker, then skip it. Segments. wrapper two. I pull up on my thread while I push that down. Make sure it's lined up right underneath. I'll take some tight wraps. And a small little head. Nice and tight. All right, we're getting there. It's starting to look like a fly, huh? Fantastic. I think we should add some eyes. What do you think? Okay, again, I'm using one of these 1/4 inch. Make sure I have a nice flat surface to glue those eyes on to. I'm actually going to glue these just a little bit forward than I did the last time. I'm going to try to, what I'm going to aim for is the center of the eye to line up right up with the edge of the thread. At least that's the plan. I'm going to have a glue. That's what I was aiming for. Another dab of glue. And another eye. This is kind of the spot where everybody learns where super glue will never stick to what you want it to do, but it will stick to your fingers if you're not careful. I will let that set for a second, then we'll get a little insurance policy. This case will be in the form of some solar res UV curing resin. Alright, here we go. First time I'm going to add a little drop right between the eyes. Set. Flip that over. Right now I'm just gonna split the difference underneath. And I'm not gooping all the way up and around all the eyes and all that jazz. Just filling that gap, filling that hole in between. Quick little set, and I think one mistake can also be made of just, if you're messing around with this UV resin, just gooping it on and just going bananas with it. Mess it around. I'm going to give it one last round of bone dry. You know, I too have seen videos of using the resin or whatnot to make a spot to adhere the eyes. But I guess my theory is, I want to give it a nice rough texture for that glue to work its way into. This is fantastic. But, I mean, ultimately, in the end, I mean, there's 1,001 ways to glue on eyes and stick them on and make sure they don't come off, but I think this might be it. See, this is based off of some advice given to me. I asked the question. So right now the river level's low. The bass aren't everywhere, but they are everywhere. Where they are on the beds. And, you know, wading through, I see these bass, and I'm like, hey man, what's going on? How come you're not taking my flies? And they're just sitting on their beds. And the advice to me was, gotta aggravate them, gotta make that bass angry. So here we are with a little minnow. We're going to swim this guy through right over those beds and see if Papa Bass comes swooping by and goes, hey, lay off my lady's bed. There we have it. What do you think? Questions, comments, concerns? What's going on, everybody? Just waiting for the chats to pop up and catch up. So what was everybody's favorite pattern thus far in the call that the hairline dub and fly tying kit? What's your favorite video? What pattern are you looking forward to tying, and what pattern are you apprehensive to tie but you're still looking forward to tying it? I guess those are my questions. We'll let you guys respond to those questions. What your favorite hairline dubbing instructional video is. And I'm going to take a quick break, and when we come back, we're going to continue tying some more minnows. Yeah, so there you have it. All right, we'll be right back, folks. Thank you. All right, here we are, second half of our program tonight. What's up, what's up? All right, let's catch up here. Frank said, it looks good. Dale Sanders says, very nice. And Frank also said, I liked the foam beetle where you used the wire to make the sections and the eyes. That says a lot for me. Considering it has legs, OMG. And let's see here. Josh Anderson says, look at that. The woolly worm is the one that I like. He's kind of having a hard time with the size 18. I just got to get the super cheaters on. Hey, you know, that's what makes it fun. The challenge. Make it your own, and remember, it doesn't have to look like the picture in the book to be an okay fly. Don't beat yourself up. I know I won't. So anyways, let's continue and tie some more flies. What do you say? Secure blank hook. Oops, that's sad. There we are. Lead-free wire. So I'll be giving everybody an update sooner than later in regards to the rod building competition. Just waiting on some further information from above. Downside to these minnows is there's no hackle time. Don't worry, that's just me knocking things over. All right, let's start our thread up front. Gotta take that down. A few more passes over top of that lead-free wire. Securing that down gluten tight. About it rolling around or getting lost, add a little dab of a head cement in there. All right, flash. Let's get some flash. And I'm just gonna use a little bit of this yellow, golden yellow Northern Lights flash. Any old flash will do. Lift and lower it right underneath and set it on top. Full length, take a couple of wraps. And then fold it towards the back. It's a beautiful thing. Alright, so I've got one last big section here. This might be enough for one fly, so we're going to take this and just divide it into four sections. And sometimes I think if you take your material and divide it out ahead of time, it keeps you from going too... Oh, what's the word? Dense. Because what's the word we're looking for? Sparse is nurse. I'm just preparing my hair here. I'm not going to need too much, so we're just going to grab a little section. Multiply by dividing. We once had one. Now we have two, where we once had two. We now have four. All right, first little batch. Push that out. Taper out our tips. Let's go right about 50-50. Sit right on top. A couple of wraps. Locking that down. Fold that back. And we'll wrap right in front. Not on top, but in front. Advance our thread forward a little bit. Oh, we're going to add a little bit of flash. So we're just going to take two strands. Two, three strands. Yep, this is very similar to the ones like we did out at the VFW when we met out there. It seems like forever ago now. Tied these out at the VFW, we used wig hair, synthetic kinekalekalekalon. Split that out, make a little Y out of it. That way I can go around that end of that hook. Couple of soft wraps to capture it. A few more locking wraps with increased tension. Use our little magic Bic tool. We'll just build a little ramp, a little speed bump up front, locking that hair up and back. So thread forward a little bit. Sorry about that. Had to itch my ear, but I forgot I had headphones on. Oops. So in this first batch, we just added our flash before we did this, and this time we're going to add it here in the middle, because we have options, and we can use that to our best advantage. And I just wanted to show you a couple of different places to tie in your flash. Pinch it right on top. Now we'll add our white on the bottom. Nice tight locking wraps, and push this back. All right, build our little cone right up front to it, not on top, but up front to it. One last time, and we're going to stop our thread about that eye's length behind the eye, eye. All right, Dave Coleman is headed off to his bench to tie some, it's basically kind of similar to what we're tying here, more or less, in the spirit of, I'll call it, but Dave's are a lot bigger. This is on a size 2, and Dave is going for that 3-aught. And I believe you are using that actual wig hair, or are you going to be using Congo hair like we're using tonight? I know you do have some of both. That front portion up a little bit further, a little bit longer up front, which when we fold back will be the cat's meow. Crowded on the eye up here. So we'll just have to be smart. Trim this back just a little bit back here. One last little bit of flash up top. Get our crystal flash for the sides. And again, I'm just going to do 1, 2, 3. 3 strands. Tie it in full length. About the halfway point. Rotate it around. What can I say? I like the crystal flash. And again, we're just going to come in with the same 1, 2, 3 strands on the far side. And what I guess you see a lot of on videos is people will just take a piece like that. I Let's add a little dab of red. A little red gilligills. 1, 2, and 3 for the party. Fold that in half. 3 will become 6. Now we got 12. I'll even up those tips a little bit. Couple soft wraps. Go up and then fold that down. Boy, we sure definitely got a lot closer to the eye of the hook on this one. That's alright. Finish yourself with a 1, 2, 3. This one didn't feel right. There we go. All right. We're almost there. Almost done. As you brush that out, don't forget you have a brand new tip of a hook right there ready to bite you. Alright, let's go ahead and squish our head down just a little bit right behind the thread head. Give us a nice little solid base to glue our eyes into. Little dab of glue, yeah. We got our 1/4 inch mirage eye. I like it. Dab of glue, yeah. That's close to even. The fish will laugh at me if it's not. People think the fish don't laugh at you, but they do. You ever seen a fish jump out of the water? You know why they do that? Because they ain't got no middle finger. Alright, let's find our UV resin. We're gonna just add a little bit between the eyes and onto the thread. Got your flashlight at the ready. Because One time I went to do this, and wouldn't you know, my UV light was in the other room. And you want to see me run fast, because it just goops and drips and just wants to get all over the place. Alright, let's do the same thing underneath. And again, I'm not gooping this all over the whole head. Just filling in the gap between the eyes, if there's any gap. And a couple of quick zaps just to set it initially. There you go, excellent. We got a comment. Enjoy tying the foam beetles. Tied a couple of them using some green foam and then used green felting as a dubbing. Ooh, like pool table green? Like kind of like that kind of felting? Because that'd be pretty cool. Good spot to brush your flies out is you hold your fly by the head and set it on your lap and use your pant leg as a base and you can brush that all out. Yeah, buddy. The eyes do make it come alive. I'm a big fan of flies with eyes. I think flies with eyes really trigger that predator instinct. These are kind of tough to tie. These are 30-minute flies, man. What can I say? Oh, I think the with the eyes and the flash, that little bit of red. I tell you what, just add water, and this is gonna. It's gonna swim pretty well. I am actually. I might have to sneak out to the water tomorrow. Don't tell Jess. Mm-hmm. Well, I think we're gonna have time for probably one more. Yeah. You can do one more. That's for sure. So I'm going to reach out to you, my Project Healing Waters kind of a base group. As far as moving forward with kind of additional videos and stuff, what do you guys want to see? Because I've got some downtime, and I do have downtime. I'm going to sit down and tie some flies, and if I'm going to sit down and tie a fly, I'm going to hit that record button, or hit that live stream button, rather, and just go bananas. Just add water. It's interesting, because I think it was... Today, I saw on a Facebook memory or something. Where'd it go? This is probably one of my... This is how far I've come. This is what I've tied in the past. Having no idea what I was doing. Portions are all right, but as far as material, I don't know. My eyes just don't have it on this one. Oh, wait. If we look real closely. There's actually hooks in there. Forgot about these. So these are my runoffs and my no-goes. For a fly tying contest. There you go, you can see just a little bit. That was fun. Can you see the eye in there? The hook in the eye? I do a lot of weird things, what can I say? Let's do one last one. Ouch! I'm gonna put this on mute for a second and just cry. That's smart, I'll tell you that for free. Let's see, where'd we go? Shazam. Good old mustad turdy tray, 66. .020 lead free wire, just to give it a little bit of added weight to this. How much is it? Not that much, but it's not nothing. Sometimes with these synthetic hair streamers, They do sink, but they're not super quick to get down. So a little bit of encouragement in the inner core might be what's needed. Oh, we gotta switch this back. Sorry about that. There we go. Need a production manager. I need a producer. Not a producer. Would that be a producer or a director? I need a director. Remind the AV graphics guy to do his job. Original Woodstock poster is pretty cool, but I don't think y'all want to see it all day. Not throughout the whole live stream. Wrap right on top of that lid-free wire. Three days of peace and music. It wasn't advertised, but there was also a whole lot of love happening. The gold in there, a little bit of that tan, a little bit of that white. I think that'll work. Split that into, oh, I might need just a little bit more. Dividing this hair into four little sections on the bench. Nice. I think for the very first time my air conditioner just kicked on. It's 80 degrees in this house. Okay, Pete. Set that right on top. Fold it back. And again, we're wrapping in front of the hair. We're not wrapping on top. Thread forward a little bit and we'll add in some more hair. just because. We need to prepare a little bit of weight for the belly. And that's going to be half as long. And tight thread wraps. Our little specialty tool. Boy, that works out nice. Before, taper out the ends. Go two bananas with a flash, just a couple of strands. A little bit of white for the belly. Make it count. Little flash dance. Ooh, flash dancer. Did we tie a flash dancer? Tied a dirty hippie. Flash dancer, flash dancer, flash dancer. When did we tie a flash dancer? Is that a fly that we tie? I don't know why that's sticking in my head. Makes sense. Sounds like a fly we would tie. Strands for the top. All Josh, you have not tied a flash dancer. Frank, have you tied a flash dancer? Have I tied a flash dancer? I don't know. I'd have to, I'm sure they've been tied. I probably was over in, Willy Bugger World. Doing my thing over there. Give ourselves just a little bit more room on this one, which is all right with me. Whip finish. Flash dancer. Flash dancer. Help me, somebody help me remember that. Flash dancer, flash dancer. I'm trying to remember. So what should we tie next week? Should we try to do a flash dancer if possible? Otherwise, what should our plan be? Plan B be. Some slightly different eyes. This last one. This is a little bit bigger, a lot bigger. We're gonna go slightly larger eyes this time. Just cause, I don't know, I like variety. I'll use the flat part of our scissors. We'll squish down on that surface area just a little bit. Nice big oversized eye on this one. Because it's fun. How many weeks have we been at this live streaming for Project Healing Waters? It's been, what, 8, 9 weeks, 10 weeks? Coming up soon. Oh, you know what we forgot to do? We forgot to do our red crystal flash. I got some red marker. Here we go. Saved it. Gray and white hair. It could pass it off as a mullet. Heck yeah, man. Business in the front, party in the back. All right, little dab of glue in between the eyes. We're gonna call this a thing. Oh yeah, did I mention these ones glow in the dark? Now how in the world did that happen? After all that, bit of that wire stuck out. Here we go. No worries. Like I missed a spot, but boy, and how it's there. It's just clear. Alright, one last final coat, and this bad boy will be a bad boy. When I say this glows in the dark, see, that's one also another thing to consider is fish see things from a different spectrum, and I don't know if they're catching a lot of the ultraviolet spectrum. That's gonna be hot. So there we are. There we have it. Another week has gone by. Did we decide what we're going to tie next week? I don't know. Let's go ahead and wind this bad boy down. We're down at the final straw. So, I've been keeping all my Project Healing Waters flies that we've been tying here, and I could easily go back and just review the playlist. But so far, we have Clousers, Foam Hoppers, Poppers with Cyclopses. We've got Woolly Buggers, Mop Flies, Muddlers, Creelix, Pass Lake Streamer, Dirty Hippie, Matukas, Patriot Streamers, Timberwolves, Foam Beetles, and now, what do we want to call this? Just a synthetic streamer, I guess. I don't know, this needs a little bit more of a name. Let's name this fly before we call it a night. The color, what was it? It was a gold shad. So maybe we'll just call it the Golden Shad. I think this one's my favorite. The proportions. It's amazing what the difference with the eyes can make. Sorry, I'm over there playing with the flies. Well, I don't know what the fly was. The Flash Dancer. Flash Dancer. Flash Dancer. Alright, I got a memo written. Flash Dancer. We should be good to go. Alright, well, we're gonna go ahead and leave it at that. It's been a fun day. It's been a long day. Thank you all for sticking around, tuning in, and tying along if you were tying along. Be sure to check these videos out after the fact if you want to go back and review what you missed. Or if you just want to hear my lovely voice again while you take a nap. That's fine too. Be sure to hit that thumbs up button. I really appreciate getting those likes. They make me feel good. Leave comments. I love comments. It sure beats all the spam and the trolls that jump on. So, until then, until next week, I have no idea what we're going to actually tie. I'll try to get ahead of the game just a little bit and do the pre-notification, whatever, for... We're going to tie next week, so... Alright, thank you all for watching. Stay healthy, everybody. Stay safe. Happy tying. Yeah, sure, you betcha. Tight lines. Peace. Thank you.